Good morning, guys. Soul Intuition here. Just to give you guys an update. It's a little too much. Update into the third date with who I call Hunky Teacher Guy. He's really cool. I'm actually going to write a blog post about it for my blog because I can't keep up videos on my blog. But for those of you who do follow me here, you know, I'm making this video post especially for you. But still, go to my blog and follow. Thank you. It's shesdatingagain.blogspot.com, and I'll make sure I put a link down there for you guys, okay? In the info box or whatever. Okay, so we went to Ruth Chris's steakhouse last night for a wine tasting, like pairing with the dinner. And the winemaker was Chateau Saint Michel. And let me tell you guys, it was amazing. I'm not a wine person because I used to think I was like allergic to wine because it used to make me gassy and make my stomach bloated. But maybe I was just drinking the wrong types of wine. So because last night that did not happen. I was just kind of sipping it because I wasn't sure if it would do that. So, you know. Anyway, he had to tutor a kid yesterday. So I actually picked him up where he was tutoring. And, yeah, so everything went on time as well. At first, he was saying he might have to cancel his tutoring session because I was dumb. I asked him to go to this event, and I didn't even tell him what time it was. And I didn't realize I didn't tell him what time it was. And so he told me what time he would be ready, and I'm like, oh, no, it starts at 6:30. He wanted me to pick him up at 7. I'm like, ew. So anyway, we did get the logistics worked out. He didn't have to flake on his tutoring study kid, which was awesome, because I didn't want him to flake on account of me, because actually he canceled tutoring on for our last date. He canceled tutoring, so that wasn't, he can't do that. Anyway, and he also took off work to do this, so I really appreciate that as well. Anyway, so yeah, I picked him up, and he had on his usual t-shirt and jeans, and I was just like, you know, I was looking in my rearview mirror, but then he walked up and he had two button-ups in the plastic, you know, dry cleaning bag. And then he was just like, one or two. Like, he opened the passenger door and was flipping the shirt because he had two in one bag. And I picked the purple one. It was white with, like, purple stripes, kind of. Like, it was a nice shirt. Anyway, so he went back to his car and put that on. And then he had his shoes with him. He wore flip-flops in the car, but he had his shoes with him, and he put them in my car. And I just told him to drive because since he lives over there, I was just like, he might know better ways to get there than I would, you know, instead of me plugging it in my GPS and everything. So he was like, you want me to drive? And I'm like, yeah. And it's funny, too, because I'm real funny about who drives my car. But I think since being on the ship, I lightened up a lot. So, you know, I'm not as anal about that. And plus, I didn't want to be all looking stupid trying to find a place. So anyway, tangent. Guys, the rash is getting better. Still bumps, but it's not like it was. It's a lot better. See, this side is like nothing there. Now it's just on this side. So it's cool. Anyway, let me show y'all what I looked like yesterday. I looked really good. Let me show y'all what I look like. Get the picture for you. I wore a jacket over top of it, but this is how I look. And I had some nice dressy jeans. That's what I look like. So I wore some nice dressy jeans with it and a cream blazer. It was really cute. And when I walked up, he said I looked really nice, which is awesome. And he was smiling, so I know he approved. And so anyway, let's see what happened. So we get there and we're there on time. But it was like a mixer first. And we were kind of sitting there, and actually he had to sign in too. And he's like, do I have to sign my name? And the guy's like, no. But they were really welcoming. They were like, welcome. Thank you for coming. Like with those real soft voices, it was kind of like, okay. But it was nice, and there were a lot of people kind of just standing around, and they were standing around for a long time, and as soon as you walk in, they give you a glass of wine. And so it was cool. It was real cool. I enjoyed myself. Oh, that's my alarm telling me I need to hurry up. So, you know, I'm like, man, I didn't know they were going to have some, like, mixer type of thing. Like, I'm hungry. Like, I came here hungry because it was 5 courses. So, I was like, I'm coming here hungry. Get my $90 worth. It's $90 a plate, okay? Anyway, yeah, so we mingled a little bit, but I'm not a big mingler, and I don't think he is either. So we kind of just kept to ourselves, and then we decided that we were going to get a seat at the table closest to the door. Then also, he's like, so who are you going to be tonight? He's like, I'm Del Griffin. I'm like, Del Griffin? He's like, yeah, from that movie Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. He was the shower curtain holder salesperson. And I'm like, I saw that movie, but I don't remember that character. But anyway, so he was Del Griffin, and he's like, who are you going to be? I'm like, I want to be somebody British, so I decided to be Tandy, like Tandy Newton. No last name, just Tandy. So he was Dell and I was Tandy. So we sat down in our seats and we were introducing ourselves. He really did introduce himself as Dell, but I really introduced myself as Tandy. And so anyway, this couple came. They were older, like in their 50s. And this lady had this boobs, like you could tell it was a boob job or whatever, but her boobs was all out there. And she has this tight dress on, and I'm thinking this lady's all old with these big boobs. Like, her boobs look better than mine, and I'm probably 20 years younger than she is. But anyway, so the wine guy from Chateau St. Michel, he did a presentation, and Hunky Teacher Guy and I are looking at each other like, well, when we gonna get to the food? And I was texting him under the table like, hey, I'm sorry, I didn't know there was going to be a lecture. Like, I'm hungry. Like, yeah, where's the food? He's like, but this is cool, though. Like, he's like, I'm enjoying myself. So that was cool. And then the guy who did the lecture actually sat at our table. And at first I was like, dang, why does he have to sit here? Because now we're going to have to converse with him. But no, it was cool. It was, like, really good conversation. We asked questions about, like, Virginia wineries and things like that. Because the winery, Chateau St. Michel, is actually in Washington State. But, you know, it was really good. So, the first course was ahi tuna and scallop ceviche. I liked the ceviche overall, but the scallops were colossal, and I use that word because I'm not exaggerating. They were like this big, and I don't like that for ceviche. Now the tuna was diced, and that was perfect size, and the flavor was really good. I just didn't like the scallops, so I gave him mine. He ate the whole thing, even like the garnish, and then he ate his, then he ate mine. I was just like, whatever, you must be hungry. And that was with, I'm not sure what kind of wine that was with. I don't even remember. There were like 5 or 6 different wines. And then we had a tomato and onion salad with feta cheese. And then we had filet mignon with shrimp. And that was like butter. That filet mignon, just so tender, so delectable. It was really, really good. He actually ate the rest of mine, too, on that, because I couldn't eat the whole thing. Then, he leaned over, and he's like, we are, like, the hottest couple in this at this table. I was like, we're the best-looking couple in this restaurant, I mean, in this room right now, because it was, like, in a separate little room they had the special dinner. And he was like... he laughed, but I was thinking so I was kind of thinking that when we came in, but I didn't want to say anything because I didn't want him to think I was like stuck up or something, or thought I was like the bomb. But we really were like the hottest looking couple in there, and even hotter than the lady with the fake boobs, because her boobs were hot, but her face wasn't that hot. So anyway, then what after that? Oh yeah, so I'm laughing and I'm like, I was thinking the same thing. And what was the next course? It was lamb with a blackberry glaze. Oh, it was so good. That lamb was so good. And I wanted to pick it off the bone. Remember the Navy guy who was eating off the bone by tearing the meat? I would have pulled one of those, but, you know, I got a little more class than that. But I was telling Hunky Teacher Guy, I was like, I really just want to pick this bone up and just, because you only can get so much off with a knife. And he cut my lamb for me, because, man, I was trying to cut it, and I think I was making a fool of myself. And I think I might have been a little nervous, too, because I kept dropping food. Like, it would not find my face. I would bring my fork up to my face, and it would fall on the table or something like that. So, all night, too, not just in the beginning. So maybe I was a little nervous. I don't know. But he doesn't make me nervous or anything. Plus, I was trying to figure out, like, you know, which fork to start eating with. Because they had all the forks and the glasses all lined up. You know, like, all that etiquette stuff. And I'm just like, oh, I'm so rusty at this type of thing. I used to know at one point in my life. But I know they said go from the inside out. So at least I know I used the right forks. I'm pretty sure I used all the proper forks, but in the right order. But anyway, then for dessert, it was a an apple tart with vanilla ice cream, and that was pretty good. I'm not really into apple stuff, but it was really good. So, like I said, we had a really good time, and that was on point. So then we were leaving, and what happened when we left? So we left. Oh, and we were walking back to the car, and he was walking a little bit fast, and I was just like, and it was like all these cops out there for some reason. Anyway, I said, hey, you gotta slow down, because these heels are skinny. Like, they were like stiletto heels. They weren't that high, but they're skinny, and ladies, you know, it's hard to walk in really skinny high heels, because sometimes they're kind of wobbly. And these were sandals, like strap sandals. Only it was three straps on the top. So you imagine, and the heel was like this long, so I had to walk carefully so I wouldn't look stupid. And so I told him, unless you're going to carry me to the car. And so this dude picks me up, like, and then he picks me up like a fireman carry too on top of it. And I'm like, put me down, there's cops right over here. They're going to think we drunk or something. Which I was a little tipsy, drinking all that wine, but I was okay. And he was just like, so when he put me down, y'all, he put me down with one arm, and it was, like, slow, like, I was thinking, strong, this dude is strong. That was cool. So then we walked back to the car, and then he drove by. We went back to his car, but before that, he said, do you want coffee or cupcake or anything? So I was like, maybe some chai tea. So he stopped at some bakery called Buzz and got me a chai tea latte with soy. That's how I like it. And what else after that? I got my chai tea latte, and actually he drank some of it, which I didn't even mind at all, because he's not, it's weird, like, he'll do stuff like eat my food or drink my tea without asking, and I don't mind. Well, not my food, but he did drink the tea. No, he did ask, he said, may I have some? Yeah, he did ask, okay. So anyway, we shared that on the way back to his car, and then when we got back to his car, oh, and let me tell you, I skipped something. So, like I said, the wine was making me a little heady. I have to admit, I was flirtatious during the dinner. Like, I told him I wanted, he has like a, I can tell that he had his front tooth repaired, and there's a little crack in it, and I told him I wanted to lick the crack of his tooth, and I texted him down to the table, and he said, I take what I can get. No, first, his first reply was lame, and he said that too. He was like, that was kind of lame. I think he said, my tooth? Yeah, I do have a cracked tooth. That was his response first. And then he goes, that was kind of lame, wasn't it? I was like, yeah, that was kind of lame. So then he replied back, lick my cracked tooth. Sure, I'll take what I can get. I'm like, you're not too good at this. But anyway, so, to make a long story short, when we got back to the car, by the time we got back to the car, the wine was kind of wearing off, so I was kind of back to my normal self. But he leans in to kiss me, so you know, I went with it. And he's a good kisser. We kind of kissed, and then he like just sat back, and I said, "So what you thinking?" You know, he said, "Well, you want to come back to my place?" I'm like, "Sure." So I went back to his place. It's really nice, really nice. It's right near 95 too, which was cool. It was easy for me to get back home. But anyway, I thought it was like an apartment. He said, "No, I own it." And I was like, "Oh, it's a condo." So he's like, "Yeah." And I was like, "Cool, it's really nice." And he decorated it himself and painted. And he's also an artist. And y'all, if y'all know me personally, any of my followers or subscribers who know me personally, they know I have a thing for artists. And I'm just, the last few guys I've been dating aren't artists. And maybe that's why it hasn't really panned out or whatever. I don't know. But I kind of wasn't surprised that he turns out to be an artist. He paints. And the stuff was really nice that he painted. I was like, "Oh, that's nice." Then what happened after that? He's babysitting his mom's dog, the cutest dog ever, and I played with the dog a little bit, and then I just straight up told him, I was like, "I'm not having sex with you tonight," and I said, "But we can make out," and he's like, "Okay," you know, he just went with it, and we did make out, and you know, but it wasn't too heavy, nothing real heavy, just like kissing and stuff. It wasn't like, you know, it wasn't like going in my pants or nothing like that. It was good. It was just, I don't even know, like, the basis, first base, second base. I don't know, like, he didn't like touch my breast or anything, just like rub my back and stuff like that. That was it. So, but I will say I was tempted to spend the night. But I'm just not ready to go there. So, and I told him that. I said, "You know, it's not that I'm not attracted to you. I'm just not ready to go there because there's still some things that I think you need to decide, and then we'll go from there." Because, like, I was asking him what was his damage, because, you know, we all have some type of baggage, some type of damage. So he was like, "Well, my damage is, I mean, kind of tired of dating and nothing really panning out and just taking girls out. And I kind of feel like some people just trying to get a free meal." He's like, "I mean, with the exception of you, you know," because we did go Dutch on this other one. And it was my idea to go Dutch. He was happy to pay for it. But I said, when the guy waited for when he bought the check, I was like, "Let's split it." So we did that. He was like, "You want to split it?" I'm like, "Yeah, go Dutch." I'm like, "Yeah." So we did that. But he was like, you know, he said, "But I like the fact that, you know, that you asked me out and everything." Like, because I asked him out on that date, and actually the second one, too. And he was just like, "I like that. Like, that's like what I've been waiting for, somebody to kind of show me, you know, that they're interested in me." And I'm like, "Yeah, I mean, I like hanging out with you. You're fun, and we just vibe really well together, and I like that." And I was like, and that being said, that's why I don't want to just jump, you know, and sleep with you, like, on a third date. Like, not that I have some sort of cutoff or anything like that, but anyway, this is getting long. I'll have to finish this and do a part two, because this is, like, going on 20 minutes, and I know y'all probably getting bored. All right, guys. Peace.